हेलो गाइस, मैं सेल्फ कृति शर्मा फ्रॉम एमबीए डिपार्टमेंट आर्य कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड आईटी कुकस जयपुर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट ई कॉमर्स एंड इट्स टाइप्स। द कंटेंट्स आर ई कॉमर्स डेफिनेशन, ई कॉमर्स टाइप्स, इट्स एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस। एज द पिक्चर शोज, इट इज़ अ कंटिन्यूस प्रोसेस, मीन्स 24/7 वी कैन परचेज एनी प्रोडक्ट एट एनी टाइम। Now the definition of e-commerce. E-commerce, also known as electronic commerce or internet commerce, refers to the buying and selling of goods or services using the internet and the transfer of money and data to execute these transactions. Means, as the term explains, it is a meeting point of buyers and sellers on the internet. It involves the transaction of goods and services, the transfer of funds and the exchange of data. The picture shows it is a cyclic process. First of all, we search the product, then we buy that product, or we can add that product to our cart. In next phase, we will pay for that product, and now that product will be delivered to us. So it is a continuous cyclic process. Now the different types of e-commerce. These are B2B, that is business to business, B2C, business to customer, C2B, that is customer to business, C2C, customer to customer, B2A, business to administrator, and customer to administrator. First one is B2B, that is business to business. B2B is nothing but where business transactions take place between business to business or companies to companies over the internet. And almost 60-80% of companies sells their are done through B2B. In this transaction, companies are doing business with each other. The final consumer is not involved in this process. So the online transactions only involve the manufacturer, wholesalers, and retailers. Next is B2C. B2C is completely consumer-based business, where all business transactions take place between business and consumers. In this, the companies will sell their goods and services directly to the consumers. The consumer can browse their website and look at the products, pictures, and read reviews. The consumer can place their order, and company ships the goods directly to the customer. Now, what can be the examples of this? The examples are Amazon, Flipkart, Zabang, etc. Next is C2B, that is customer to business. It applies where the consumer sells a product or a service to a business over the internet, though this companies reduce manufacturing cost. In consumer to business, the consumers provide a good or service to the company. For example, an IT freelancer is a company who demos and sells his software to the other companies. It can be a good example of C2B. Next is C2C, that is customer to customer. C2C is a marketplace in which consumer sells or purchases goods and services, sometimes for data transmission through internet to the consumer. In this process, consumers are directly contact with each other. No company is involved in this process. It helps the people to sell their personal goods and assets directly to the other party. Products can be like cars, bikes, etc. can be sell through this process. Example of C2C are OLX, Quikr, etc. Next is B2A, that is business to administrator. The term administrator relates to the public administration or government entities. Countless branches of government depend on or use e-services or products in one form or another, particularly in the areas of document management and human resources. It is an electronic means of providing business specific information such as policies, regulations directly to the business. Next is C2A, that is consumers to administrator. Consumers can be involved in this equation as well. although the government rarely buys any products or services directly from the consumers, but consumers can use this service to file their tax returns. Now, what are the different advantages of e-commerce? First of all, e-commerce provides the sellers with global reach. They remove the barrier of place. Means a consumer can buy any product at any time. So there is no barrier of place. Next is electronic commerce will substantially lower the transaction cost. It eliminates many fixed costs of maintaining brick and mortar shops. This allows the companies to enjoy a much higher margin of profit. Means companies are no need to store bulk of amount of products. So it is the advantages of e-commerce. Next is it provides the quick delivery of goods, so it saves the times of consumers as well as the companies. It saves times, energy and effort to consumers as well as companies. Next is its availability. Products are all time available to customers. They can purchase any product at any time. Next is electronic commerce also allows the customers and businesses to be in touch directly without any intermediaries. It allows quick communication and transaction, so it gives a valuable personal touch. Means the customers can directly communicate to the businessman without any intermediaries. So it is a good process of communication. Next, the disadvantages of e-commerce. The main disadvantages of e-commerce is its startup cost, because to create its e-commerce portal is very cost very high. The cost of hardware and software, and to train the employees, and the constant maintenance is an expensive process. Next is, it is not sure that your e-commerce business will be successful always. There is a high risk of failure in this kind of business. Next is security issue. The main disadvantages of e-commerce is security issue. While doing payment through credit card or debit cards, there are many security issues concerned with this. Some third party can stolen your personal information and make the fraud transactions through your debit cards or credit cards. Next is, there are also fulfillment problems. Even after the order is placed, there can be problems of shipping, or delivery can be late, or products can be mismatches. Means what kind of product you have ordered and what kind of product you are receiving, there can be a difference between these two. So it can unhappy the customers or dissatisfied. Thank you.